Here is my whirlwind solo trip to Brussels. So first I had to catch a bus to London, which was very, very early. I could barely stay awake, and bus rides can be a little bit tough. But I was interested to see what this would be like. Plus I got to see a beautiful sunrise, which is something I don't normally see because I am not a morning person. But after a lot of exhaustion and running on less than 4 hours of sleep, we made it to London, which was really exciting. So now, step one was to get to the London Underground. I don't remember which line I took, possibly Hammersmith or another. Either way, I needed to get to King's Cross St. Pancras. So it's always fun to take the tube, even if it can be a little stressful because you have to rush about because people in London walk very fast. But I do enjoy taking it, and even though I wasn't very alert, still managed to get to St. Pancras, which was pretty cool. And first thing I need to do was grab some Costa, partly because I'm hungry at this point, but also because I want to support Costa's recent allyship for trans people. Trans rights are human rights after all. So couldn't find Costa at first. Turns out it's actually on the outside of the station, not inside. But hey, I got a BAP and I think a croissant. So that was very, very good. And it was worth it. But I had to rush to the arrivals area because it is time to board. So I just about made it to the Eurostar before the doors closed. And now I'm off to Brussels. So goodbye, London. And I was excited to see how this would go. I have only taken the Eurostar once before, but I do enjoy it, and it's quite interesting to see. And also wanted to brush up a little bit on my French, do what I could. And I've done some Duolingo, but it can only do so much. And from this point, I learned that I was likely in France before I got to Brussels. It was very strange. My phone gave me a notification that said, "Welcome to France," but it didn't give me a notification that said, "Welcome to Belgium." It was very weird. I almost felt disappointed, but no matter, because it wasn't too long before we would arrive at the Brussels train station. So we got to see some very Belgian stuff, like Starbucks, Pret, the Body Shop, Sbarro, oh, and Dunkin' Donuts. So the very Belgian things. Very amusing. I got my Mobipe card. I hope I'm pronouncing it right. And I figured I would do a little walk around the city. So trying to figure out how the heck to navigate in a city where I barely speak any of the languages. A little bit fun, But it was quite interesting to see some of the kind of cool architecture. And then, yes, Mannequin Peace. There's the peeing fountain boy himself, along with some more graffiti. But in all honesty, there are actually some also cool murals around as well. And also some beautiful buildings. Right here is the Grand Place. And it was really neat to see. And inside here is the Brussels City Museum, which is also really cool. I actually tried to order my ticket in French, and the person at the counter basically switched to English right away. They figured out my French was terrible and that I am a clueless American. But yeah, there's some beautiful artwork in this museum. I really enjoyed it, along with the original Mannequin Peace statue, because of course, the original has been stolen many times, and the one you see outside is a replica. So that was cool to see. Also, if I mispronounce Mannequin Peace, I am sorry. I am terrible with Dutch, Flemish, what have you. But after that, I got some chips. Very exciting. I don't know if they are authentic. Probably not. Who cares? They were delicious. Garlic mayo was also very good. And I got some water because I was running low and I was getting very dehydrated. But after pick me up, I got to see the Tintin mural. There was a lot of Tintin around Brussels. I don't remember the reason why. Also got to Leonidas, because one of my friends used to work at a cafe there. So I wanted to check it out and get some chocolate, partly because when in Belgium, and also I was on my period at the time, so I needed chocolate. Walked around a little bit more and got to see a Jonquette piece. I'm probably mispronouncing it, but it's basically the female version of mannequin piece. And got a little bit more of the general city, which was really neat. And I was tempted to go into this library and museum. But at that point, I was getting very, very tired. And so after a little bit exploring around, I decided to go back to the hotel. And on the way, I got kind of caught in this fair of sorts, including some very creepy looking rides. Like you can see this Grim Reaper of sorts, and there are just some very kitschy rides all around. I was tempted to get some fairground junk food, not gonna lie, but still a little bit tired at that point, so I hit it to the hotel room.
All right, so I'm just staying here in the hotel room. Have been for the last couple hours or so. Haven't drunk much water today, so as a result from that and walking around a bunch, I have a pretty nasty headache. I was going to do a lot more exploring, but decided, screw it. Well, be accurate, my ankles and feet decide, screw it. No, can't walk anymore. So I'm just chilling here at the moment, but it's a very cute room. I rather like it, you know, gets the job done anyway. Originally, I was going to get dinner somewhere. I mean, this is close to the train station, so I thought I could pick something up there, but honestly, not that hungry, and head is kind of just not feeling great, so I'm really just probably eating chocolates for dinner, which is not good for you, but right now I don't care. And I mean, I'm complaining about this headache. It'll be fine once I get some sleep and some water. But yeah, it just means that I have to. I'm resting a lot more than originally planned, but you know, that's kind of why I like prioritizing kind of the things I want to see when I travel. So I kind of make a list of what are the things I absolutely want to see, and then what are the things it'd be good to see, but if I don't get to, no big deal. And so I believe I've at least seen everything today that I've wanted to, and so hopefully it'll be similar for tomorrow. Yeah, so it was a pretty good day of sightseeing, though I'm missing my kitty. And hopefully tomorrow will be really good too. I forgot I had some Graze, so I've got some actual protein for dinner, not just chocolate. So hey, well-rounded meal right here.
All right, and this was my second day in Brussels, trying to figure out how to navigate my way around the city. Luckily, I managed it okay, and I managed to get to, I believe it's called the National Basilica of the Sacred Heart. Don't ask me to pronounce that in French because I will butcher it. I didn't take any photos or anything inside, but it was absolutely stunning. I would definitely recommend seeing it, if nothing else, for the perplexing number of Benedict XVI pictures. Like, there was only one picture I saw of Pope Francis and several of Pope Benedict XVI, and I could not figure out the reason why. I couldn't find a particular connection to the basilica, but if anyone does, like, do let me know. But yeah, I also had some nice grounds nearby. I think it was located in Park Elizabeth. And I also saw this strange looking bean or nut type fountain. Not quite sure what it was, but it was pretty cool. I enjoyed it. And had to figure out my way back to the metro, but considering that I barely speak the language, it wasn't too difficult to navigate around. Then saw the Atomium. I don't know if I'm pronouncing that too, but fun fact, this was a pit stop for the Amazing Race, so that was really fun. And it's just a cool little place in general. I thought about seeing Mini Europe, which is nearby, but basically every child in Europe was there and being very loud. And I had not eaten very much, so I had to grab a quick salad, the place was just closing, but it was very good. And then I got to see the outside of the European Parliament. That was actually really cool. If I had more time, I would have figured out how to get a tour or find some way to get inside, because I'm just really fascinated by a lot of political government things, oddly. I never thought I would say that. But there was also some little bits of the Berlin Wall there, which was a very neat find. There's also some type of cool, almost peace or activism art. And around the corner somewhere, you'll see the House of European History, which I'll admit I'd never heard of until that day, but it was probably the highlight of my entire trip. Definitely recommend a visit because the quick clips that I took inside don't do it justice. So go see it. Pretty amazing. It's got a cool little tablet where you can see all the information, and it's just really fascinating and has a good overview of lots of bits of European history. And fun fact, apparently you're recommended to wash your hands for 40 to 60 seconds, not 20. So I guess I've been doing it wrong my whole life. But need to get back to England, but not before grabbing a Belgian waffle. I don't care if it's probably not authentic. It was worth it. And now to get back onto the Eurostar and head back home. And at this point, I was very tired. It was a very quick trip. But I managed to get back to St. Pancras, and now it's time to get through the London Underground and head home.
Hello, it's me. I'm just popping on here about a few weeks after my trip. I basically had very little time afterwards to kind of film me getting home, but, you know, I got home safely, got to see Sasha, which was lovely, and yeah, now I'm just plugging away. Work's getting kind of busy, so it's, you know, kind of hard not to wish for another holiday. We'll say, just to kind of summarize or wrap up all of this, that was definitely a whirlwind trip to Brussels. I think I spent just about 31 hours there, so not a lot of time. And it's one of those things where, am I glad I went on this trip? Yes. Would I take another short trip like that again? Probably not, unless there was, like, no other choice. Now, granted, you know, I was at a point where I was itching to go somewhere that wasn't the UK or US, which, I know, privileged person problems. And I could only afford to stay one night, so you know, you do what you have to do or want to do sometimes. But I do think that if I want to take another holiday in future, I would try to kind of stay minimum of two nights somewhere. Because, yeah, you can only see so much. But, yeah, that was my trip. So if you generally liked it or even parts of it, feel free to like, comment, subscribe, all of that fun YouTube stuff, and I guess I will see you soon.